Hello people, how do you do? Where do you think I am? This is Harvard Square in Boston, Massachusetts. It's the town next to Somerville, where I live, so I came to visit. Actually, I have memories of Harvard University. When I was a college student majoring in psychology in Japan,Harvard University class was broadcast on TV. The lecturer is Professor Michael Sandel, a philosopher. The class that was broadcast at that time was Justice. It was interesting at the time, and I was immersed in watching. A particularly interesting story was the trolley problem. You can choose to kill one and save five, kill five and save one, or do nothing.What would you do? By the way, I'll kill five people and save one. Because in this situation, it's easier to swear loyalty to one person than five. Then I whispered to him after helping him. I helped you because you are special. Maybe he'll swear loyalty to me for the rest of his life.If you have the same personality type as me, you should arrive at the same idea. Wouldn't it be more interesting if some people had a minority answer in the world? Jokes aside, this is the main gate to Harvard University. Today is Sunday, so main gate is closed. Instead, the next gate was open, so let's go inside. It's a splendid brick gate.Tourists not taking commemorative photos here. I took a good picture. The campus feels like a park, and the general public comes and goes freely. That's the statue of John Harvard. Touching his feet seems to bring good luck, so his feet are discouraged from being rubbed by tourists.By the way, this bronze statue is also called Statue of Three Rights. First, he is not the founder of Harvard University, but its patron. Next, the year of foundation is not 1638, but 1636. Finally, the model of the statue was just an ordinary student, because portrait of John Harvard could not be found. Big square came in sight.This is the famous Harvard Yard. By the way, this is the campus as seen from above. I would like to visit Harvard Business School, but it seems to be on a different campus, so I'm going to move from now. It's a 10-minute walk across the Charles River from Harvard University. By the way, this is the Charles River.MIT and Boston University are located along the Charles River. Both are world-class universities. Boston is the most academic city in the world. Arrived at the Harvard Business School campus. Let's go to the famous building.It's right there. Maybe this building. This is the view you often see in pictures of Harvard University. By the way, the founder of the English school I'm currently attending seems to have gotten MBA here. In Japan, the president of Rakuten got MBA here. Today, I will visit MIT, which is 10 minutes by bus from Harvard University.Do you know what MIT stands for? MIT stands for Massachusetts Institute of Technology. So, MIT is an engineering university. According to the British educational magazine, Times Higher Education, Harvard University and MIT are in the top 10 world university rankings every year. By the way, MIT is the best university in the world for engineering. What's it like?I found a mysterious building, so let's go see it. It's an engineering design. This is the MIT Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Laboratory. I can see something like a robot arm from the window.I looked it up on the internet and found the same robot. Am I good at searching? Probably there must be such a robot in the building. Or something like this. Maybe the person next to you.If you doubt he's human, I suggest touching his feet. Because it may be a human, made by humans. It may just move like a human by attaching the head, arms, and legs.By the way, a mind transfer project to avatars has already started in Russia. Its name is Global Future 2045. Please check it out. In 2021, a rally on digitalization was held in Dubai too. Of course, a similar project has been announced by the Cabinet Office in Japan as well.In fact, we may already be aliens who have transferred our consciousness to human avatars. Joke aside, this is the building as seen from above. Where is the building we often see in the picture? I came out of campus.Maybe this is the main gate? It looks like the Parthenon. I found the map. No, I've been walking like this.I've seen this object in pictures. This is an object called Alchemist. Objects are made up of numbers and formulas. Walking around campus makes me feel like an MIT student. Then I walked towards the Charles River. Finally arrived at the destination.This is the building we often see in pictures. This photo was taken on another sunny day. If it's cloudy like today, the photos won't look good. The letters Massachusetts Institute of Technology are tabbed on the wall.There is an MIT student behind the door. On the other side, you can see the Charles River. This door is open, so let's explore the inside of the building. There are a few people, because it is a holiday. There is a poster introducing the university.Photos of graduates and staff are pasted on the walls. I found a mysterious object. It's shaped like a hypercube. When you go up the stairs, something is decorated.I found a mysterious model. It seems that this is a geometric model. It looks like a UFO, doesn't it? When I saw this, I remembered a mysterious video about how to turn the sphere inside out. Maybe UFOs are human vehicles used in the military.UFO that transforms in the sky like this is also based on geometry. This is the world that ordinary people will never know. However, they are not hiding from the common people. While the common people are working according to the script made by the government and working hard to revitalize the economy, they use the money they earn to save the planet.Yes, they are the space horse. Rest assured that black funds are being used effectively. By the way, warp drive technology is already complete. You can find a lot of information about time travel if you look it up. For example, the gravitational wave experiment predicted by Einstein. The existence of gravitational wave was discovered in 2015 at the LIGO Gravitational Wave Detection Facility in the United States. This is an experiment that warps space-time when two neutron stars merge. Then, the black hole that appeared in the distorted space-time leads to another universe. In other words, the wormhole is complete.For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, let me explain this phenomenon with a video. Einstein's general theory of relativity states that objects have gravity. Then, space-time is distorted when an object with weight moves. The waves generated at this time are called gravitational waves. If you visualize gravitational waves, it looks like this. You can see that the surface is wavy.So, let me explain why wormholes occur. When two black holes merge in this way, they create a more massive black hole and open a hole in space-time. It is an image that the surface becomes dented when a heavy ball is dropped into the net. In other words, if the combined ball is too heavy, it will penetrate the net and make a hole.Like this, a big hole opens. Then, what should we do to generate a wormhole realistically? The method is simple. First, prepare a rocket. Next, rotate the rocket at high speed. In this way. If rotation is difficult, you can use the warp drive spacecraft announced by NASA. If you are interested,Check out NASA's Eagleworks laboratories. Then, generate two gravitons around the rotating rocket. Of course, the gravitons are also spinning, because the rocket is spinning. Then, the gravitons attract each other. And the space-time is distorted by the weight of gravity and a wormhole occurs. This is the method of spatio-temporal travel.With the time dilation, you will be able to go to the future Earth. By the way, Star Wars is a true story. Speaking of which, Recently, SpaceX has been launching rockets frequently. Probably they are time traveling. Space-time travel is frequently taking place in the sky, just because the common people don't know about it. This is a video of Hawaii. This is New Zealand. This is Norway.Numerous evidence videos have been featured on TV news. My delusions aside, let's continue exploring MIT. Anyway, now I don't know where I'm walking. For now, let's check outside the window. I see, I figured out where I am.What do we have here? This is the poster for particle interaction. What is that? Is that the plutonium used in nuclear weapons? Scary! This is the poster about the history of the universe.This is the poster about nuclear power. What is this? This is the Higgs boson. The Higgs boson reminds me of CERN in Switzerland. Quantum teleportation experiments are being conducted here. I want to be transported to another world through this hole.Human size should be able to teleport easily. Stargate technology has been around for a long time. Eisenhower's great-grandson testifies about Project Pegasus. Actually, I have clairvoyance, so ordinary people can't follow my conversation. But that's just me. MIT is interesting.Some people play with electric surfboards on the Charles River in front of MIT. Now then, where should I go next? Come to think of it, the robots we often see on YouTube were also made by a company in Boston. The name is Boston Dynamics.By the way, this video is from 10 years ago. Obviously used for military purposes. I wouldn't be surprised if this was on the Ukrainian battlefield. This technology is not being used by DARPA for military purposes. Of course, it's not open to the public. It takes about an hour by bus from MIT to Boston Dynamics.So, I immediately came to here. This is Boston Dynamics. I came here for a tour. Will I be allowed to visit? There is the same robot that I saw on YouTube. According to employees, there are no tours and the robots are not open to the public. A robot is kept in the kennel.I wanted to see the dog in motion. It took me over an hour to get here, but I couldn't go inside. I can't help it, so let's wait for the public release of the new robot on YouTube. We humans have strong anxiety about pregnancy.Because it puts a strain on your body and shortens your life. But would you be worried if you could have access to artificial womb? This information is common knowledge about the rich and the intelligent. You can create genetic information for your child's eye color, hair color, skin color, physique in advance. By the way, I don't think it will spread to the common people. Like the technology of longevity,It seems that only intellectuals are using it. On the other hand, People in the countryside will continue to get pregnant and give birth even after 100 years. The technology of the future already exists, even if the common people don't know about it.
Thank you.